Regardless of the many developments and changes in society over the years, we have not been able to increase time. We may talk of improving technology and other tools to increase productivity, but as a people, we still have 24 hours a day for every person, from the newborn baby to the busiest executive. The skill of time management is timeless and remains a key principle for getting ahead in pursuit of our goals. We cannot actually manage time. What we can do is to learn how to manage ourselves better and to use the time we have optimally. Think about this. You can lose your money and earn it back. But when you lose time, it's lost forever. The exact minute or hour would never come back. The big uncertainty about time is that we don't even know how much time we have in this world. Time is seen in terms of past, present, and future. The past represents the time we have already spent, and we are reminded of this every birthday. Age is a factor of time. The past we value because of the lessons we can learn from the past experiences, the lessons that we can apply to the present and the future. The future we know nothing about. We can only anticipate with hope, but we can use the lessons of the past to plan for the future. We must remain open-minded to the changes that might occur given the uncertain future. The present is the now. This is a gift that we must unwrap carefully and optimize. The gift of the present unfolds every minute. The present is key because it's the only time we have to work with right now. There's a growing recognition of the importance of mindfulness and the need for awareness of the power of now. The effective use of time is key to success in life, career, or business. We use time to pursue our goals, whether it's to build relationships, to play sports, to build our businesses, exercise, and to basically do whatever we consider to be important in our lives. Developing quality relationships takes time. Building a successful career takes time, and developing important skills takes time. Yet, despite the importance of time, it's a perishable resource and cannot be stored. Think about it. If the services you offer are based on time, then what you offer is perishable. You have to find ways to package it in a way that it can be used in your absence or in multiples per use or in multiple uses. Some time ago, when training lawyers on how to manage a legal practice as a business, some were surprised when I said that legal services are perishable. But this applies to many services. So long as your service is based on time and is charged on the basis of time, then it's perishable. This is because when there is no service being rendered and nothing being developed, that time passes and it will not be charged to anyone. Yet, when the time passes, it's gone forever. Another challenge is that we cannot store time for later use. We either use it optimally now or let it be. The time does not stop because of the pandemic or other happenings that disrupt daily life. So all the time lost to many people and businesses during this pandemic is now gone and gone forever. Time is an inelastic resource. It's not subject to the forces of supply and demand. Regardless of the demand, it does not increase. The most idle person with no agenda at all has equal time with the busiest executive. This means that we need to treat time with great respect. Let me propose 7 quick ways to optimize time or improve time management. 1, align time to goals. Ensure that the way you use your time is consistent with your goals. To test this, list the main activities that take your time and compare that with your goals. If there is a gap, you need to review your activities or your goals to ensure that there is alignment. For most people, it appears like there are always more things to be done than the time available. This calls for allocating time to what matters most to you. Focus your time on deepening your relationships, for example, or developing your career, or growing your business, for spiritual growth, or personal development, or for enhancing your health and well-being, the things that truly matter. Number two, prioritize your main tasks. Use the early morning time for your most important activities. This is the greatest quality time when you are more creative. Tap into that power of inspiration to get the most important things done. Most of us tend to check our phones and social media and emails early in the morning. The problem with this is that you find yourself responding to other people's agendas before doing what you have planned to do. What is in your agenda? The other challenge with this is that it starts to disrupt your morning routine. It tends to be habit forming and may become the routine itself unintentionally. So when you find yourself doing this, you know, checking social media and the like and your phone in the morning, you need to shift the focus to your own agenda. Number three, schedule your day ahead of time. That is, decide what you will do tomorrow, today. Use today to clarify what you want to spend tomorrow on. This helps keep your time focused and avoid situations where you'll be driven by other people's agendas. Number four, do accounts for your time. Similar to the way we do accounts for our money, we need to do accounts for our time. This will help develop accountability for the most important and the most scarce resource that we all have. And this resource is critical for our success. So if you did a balance sheet for your time, how would you say that the accounts are balancing? How about a comprehensive time usage statement? How would it look like? I think that is an interesting way of changing our perspective about time. Number five, apply the Pareto principle. This is the 80-20 rule, which basically says that you get about 80% of your results from 20% of your activities. That means that these are the most important activities, and that is where you should focus your time. You know, when we look at the time and activities, we always classify activities into four categories: the important but not urgent, the important but urgent, the urgent but not important, and that which is not urgent and is also not important, which means you should not even be doing it at all. Number six, learn to say no. You need to learn to say no to those things that do not complement your goals. You don't have to attend meetings and events that have nothing to do with your goals and where also you have no role. You also need to consider what to say yes to. Every time you say yes to something, you are saying no to something else. So guard your no's and your yeses, because that determines where you apply your time, your greatest resource. Number seven, train and delegate. Learn to train others and to delegate some of the activities to them. This way, you will release your time to your most important activities. One of the ways to test this is to ask yourself when you're doing an activity, is this the most economical or most important use of my time? So it would mean that you can release some activities to be done by others, an assistant, or even outsource it so that you can have more time to spend on the most important activities, whether it's building a business, building your career, loving your family, sharing time with your people, the things that matter. To sum it up, my seven ways to enhance time management are: one, align your time to your goals. Two, prioritize your main tasks. Three, schedule your day ahead of time. Four, do accounts for your time. Five, apply the Pareto principle. Six, learn to say no. And seven, train and delegate. Before I close, I have a question for you. What one action will you take in the next few days to improve your time management? Remember to subscribe, like, and keep watching. We all need to elevate our mindsets at this time. Thank you and best wishes.